بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we continue with session 5. The title will be Image Edge Detection. This has been discussed as an introduction in the last video. Let's recap this part. So what is Image Edge and what are the edge detection tools and procedures that can be taken to get or to extract the edges from the images. As we said before, edge detection is very useful in many applications. As you see here in the lane road, the lane lines on the road are detected by a smart system. This is one of the applications that can be used for, based on edge detection by detecting the lanes. The lane lines, the red, the yellow one in the middle, and the white one on the borders. So, what are the edges? We said that edges are places in the image where we have a strong intensity contrast. So, where we have a variation or a quick transition in gray levels in a given area, this will give us the border between the two areas, dark and bright regions in the area, will be defining an edge. Of course, edges are, or any edge can be consisted of pixels. So the edge pixel is a pixel where a quick transition occurs in brightness. So where we have a quick transition, a change in the value, in the brightness in an image, we can say that this is an edge pixel. Now, if we combine all edge pixels, we could get something like edge, and the edge in this case will be as a group of edge points or edge pixels. So edges are places in the image where we have strong intensity change or contrast or variation in the brightness. This slide was also discussed in the previous lecture. Now, as you look here, you can see an ideal edge, a quick transition between the dark or the black and white. And this is the ideal edge. This is the value of the brightness taken in a line, because we have the same value for all lines. While here we have a smooth change or a smooth edge, and the edge cannot be easily detected because of the smoothness of, or the gradual change in the edge content, and this is a real, actually a real edge, and it's a smooth type or a smooth type of edges. In this figure or in this image, you can see the fingers motion, and we have here sensors on the top of the fingers, and we can detect edges by having these points showing or indicating the fingers or the finger itself. Also, in the last session, we said, or we talked about, sorry, here we have some sharing issue. We talked about how we can detect edges. So we know that the edge is the quick change in brightness or in variation in the in contrast. So what are the approaches that can be taken for edge detection? We said that we may approximate the first derivative using differences, because we have in discrete form, we have the derivatives will be converted into difference equations. We have three types: non-directional filters or edge operators. We have directional. In this case, we have, as we discussed before, we can define the edge in the first type, but in the second type, we can define the edge and its angle or its orientation. So it's a directional edge approach. Now we have another type, which is called the compass. Here we take eight basic directions, like the compass, using eight different Kern matrices or masks. And in this case, we can define the maximum value as a result of convolution, will be indicating the direction of this edge and the value itself. This is for the first derivative. We sometimes may use the second derivative. In the case of the second derivative, we are looking for the zero crossing point. As I told you before, when we have a first derivative like this one, so there's a peak somewhere here. We have a peak in the gradient or in the slope of the brightness values. But we have in this case to define the edge, and it could be happening at more than one point. Because, for example, if we have a value of, let's say, 10, then we rise up to 20, to 50, then to 100, and then to 200. So there is an edge in every point in this case. So we have the edge value here will be 40. The difference between the two successive pixels. Here we have the value of 50. And finally, we have a value of 100 as a difference between adjacent pixels. So where is the edge exactly? We have three points, 40, 50, and 100. This is the problem with the first derivative, because you can define any slight change in the gray level or in the magnitude will give you an edge. And in this case, you need to use thresholds. So we can go and skip to the second order or the second derivative, where we can get the point of zero crossing. When we have the second derivative, we may get something like this one. In the second derivative, we have a point of zero crossing. At this point, the edge occurs. Why? Because there will be a change in the value. We look for the maximum of the gradient or the first derivative when the second derivative passes zero value, because we have here an extreme point changing from dark to bright or from bright to dark. Examples on this, we have the Laplacian operator or the rotationally invariant derivatives or edge detectors. We mean here by when you rotate the kernel matrix, the values in this matrix are symmetrical and there will be no change to define the edge direction. And this is based on the idea of the sum of second derivatives. In Hanjma, the second derivatives within this matrix, and we get a value, and there is no angle is defined because we have a problem with the direction that cannot be defined because the matrix is rotationally invariant. In Mahamana final matrix, there is no change. There will be no change in the shape. This will be seen later and will be very clear. And for the zero crossing on the second derivative, this is basically was defined for the first time by the by Kani, and it was a PhD thesis written on this topic, and it actually gives a very good result in case of edge detection techniques, edge detection cases. Now we have also other approaches. Yes, we have other approaches that are not dependent on the first or the second derivatives. They are based on other alternative ideas like morphological filters, the Hof transform. We can use also frequency domain applications like the wavelet transform, etc. And this will be discussed in later lectures. Okay. So let's start with the first type of edge detection techniques. The first and second derivatives. Let's go and see how to define the first derivative. In a continuous world, we have, and for 1D signal, this is, for example, a signal that varies in value in terms of time, in respect to time. And we want to find the first derivative, df over dx. This upside down triangle is the gradient. In analog form, it's df over dx. While in the digital form or in the discrete form, we have to find only the sum, or sorry, the difference, the change between the pixel adjacent pixels. So f of x plus 1 minus f of x. And in this situation, we get an approximation for the first derivative. Now, for the second derivative, now we can approximate the second derivative as here you have, if we integrate, if we differentiate f of t at this point and take to find f prime of t, we get something like this one, where we have the this point is, it looks like the maximum change at this point, and this will get indicate us or give us the zero crossing point at time t equals zero. Now, for the second derivative in the discrete form, we need to find the gradient of the gradient of f, and this is the second the operator is the second derivative in the difference form. And if you repeat this one for if fx plus 1, you find the derivative, you will get something like fx2 minus 2 fx plus 1 plus f of x. So you differentiate, or you find the difference of the first derivative or the first order difference, and this gives you as being, if you are looking at f of x, you need to take f of x plus 2 minus 2 f of x plus 1. So you are taking two neighbors. This can be done for forward neighbors, for next neighbors, or maybe for the previous ones. In our situation here, we have the next neighbors after 1 pixel and then after 2 pixels for fx plus 2. Okay. Then here, بشكل عام, فكرة الديريفاتيف تحول لديفرنس in the digital form. And this is a good thing because it simplifies our task. وممكن نعمل first and second derivative. This is in one dimension. Now, what to do in two dimensions? We need to repeat in the direction of columns instead of the direction of the row itself. And this will give us different types of operators. Now, the main idea is to look for the maximum magnitude of the derivative. Yeah, we find a maximum value of the derivative, هذا معناه to find an edge. Otherwise, we don't have an edge. Now, the value of this gradient will be varying. It will not be either 0 or 1. It will be different values. For example, 10 minus 20, 100, etc. How to select? One of the good approaches is to take a threshold. بمعنى, you know, if we have a value of the gradient at this point higher than the threshold, for example, 20, مثلا عندنا كان 20, whether it is plus or minus, this means that there is a transition, and this transition is having a 20 grade level change. So if you assume, you know, 20, this is a good threshold, you can apply the thresholding. And this is one of the problems in the threshold selection, because this threshold may be good for you, it may be not good for me. It may be good for an application, it may be bad for another one. Now, the set of pixels or the value of pixels that are having a value higher than a threshold, or in other words, that obtained the value of 1, this means that we have, in this case, an edge pixel or a set of edge pixels, which means that we have an edge. يعني بنجمع كل النقاط اللي فيهم الـ value أعلى من threshold, بمعنى أنه gt of x and y having a value of 1. إذا هاي النقاط جمعناهم من بهاي الحالة بنعتبر أنه we have an edge. يعني طريقة سهلة, بنطلع الـ gradient وبنشتغل على هذا الأساس. طيب, طبعا هذا شوية بده calculations. طبعا ما تنسوش انه الجريدبل او الفاليو 1 و 0 هذول اللي موجودات في المعادله, ذيز ار لوجيكال فاريبلز. يعني ال 1 مينز وايت, البلاك مينز 0, و 0 مينز بلاك. سو وين وي تيك 1, ذيس مينز وايت, اند ذيس مينز ا جريدبل اوف 255, وير ذا بلاك مينز ا فاليو اوف 0, ا جريدبل 0. أول إنج أوبريتر كان روبرتس, وكان very simple فكرته, عبارة عن مش ماسك, وعبارة عن calculation, يعني ما في استخدام الماسك بشكل واضح. خلينا نشوف كيف المعادلة تاعته. بقولك والله we take الآن two different equations to calculate or to find the edges. الآن إيش بالضبط في عندي؟ As you see here, we have f of x and y, minus of x minus y minus x minus 1 y minus 1. يعني احنا بنعمل difference ما بين البكسل والبكسل اللي كان in the previous row and in the previous column. بنجمع طبعا بنربع الديفرنس عشان اذا كان plus or minus. بعدين نعمل ايش؟ difference ما بين f of x y minus 1 f of x minus 1 y. يعني ناخذ البكسل اللي كان قبله بسطر مطرح من البكسل كان قبله بعمود، وبعدين نعمل ايش؟ summation عفوا squaring، وبنعمل square root to get for this value. طبعا هي سميناها expensive because we are thinking the square root. To simplify our task we can use the absolute value. طبعا معروف انه بالكمبيوتر the operation the absolute value is much speeder than higher speed than the square root. إذا instead of taking the square root طبعا هي تكون exact تعطينا value أحسن. Well, this one is good and it's a compromise solution to make the calculation very quick. طب ليه بدنا الكالكوليشن يكون سريع؟ لأنه we are dealing with images of, let's say, we have an image 1000 by 1000 pixels, around 1 million pixels. This will mean it will take a lot of calculations and this will take some time or a delay. To reduce this delay, we can use the absolute value instead of the what we say the squaring root. Or the squaring equation and the square root of the squaring. One, the Roberts operator is non-directional. شو يعني non-directional؟ إنه ال edge ما the operator ما بيعطيك ال direction تاع ال edge. إنه هذا ال edge vertical, horizontal, 45 درجة. So you cannot define the direction for this edge at this point. You just take the value. So if we have an edge, the value will be high. If we do not have an edge, the value will be very small. إذا عملنا زي ديمو بسيط. This is the technique used in Roberts operator. إذا نأخذ إحنا البكسل at one row and one column before. طبعا إحنا نحكي عن البوينت أو اللي هي البكسل إحنا under concentration تاعنا هيو. هذا البكسل نتعامل معه. نرجع سطر وعمود ونطرحهم ونطلع سطر ونرجع عمود ونطرح الفاليوز بالاسهم اللون ازرق وبنطلع القيمه الان. If this value obtained سواء كان بايكويشن 1 او ايكويشن 2 has a value higher than the threshold, this means that we have an H pixel. Otherwise we do not have an H pixel and we need now to select T experimental. يعني الاجهزه لازم نستخدمها باستخدام trial and error and see the result. يعني كل مره بنعمل تشيك ونتاكد الكواليتي كويسه او لا. And هاي واحده من الاشياء اللي ممكن تكون يعني مش عامل كثير صراحه لانه it may depend on the threshold. However, this is a simple application and can usually get applicable thresholding or applicable edge detection tool. An example على الروبرت هي عندنا صورة edge image عفوا this is a grayscale image and these are the edge values taken from the edge. طبعا هنا لازم تلاحظوا if we zoom the I'll try to zoom this part. Okay. سؤال هنا في thresholding ولا لا وليش؟ في حد بيعرف؟ طبعا احنا عندنا هون اذا شايفين هون في برايت اريا هون في ايجز لكن دارك اريا هون نفس الشيء في برايت اند دارك ريجنز. اذا ما استخدم ثريشولد واستخدم الايج روبرت اوبريتر وذاوت تيكينج ذا ثريشولدينج ممكن بعد ثريشولدينج تطلع الايج بشكل احسن. لكن هو عباره عن دايركت ابلكيشن على الروبرت وذاوت ابلاينج الثريشولدينج. واضح الفكرة؟ اوكي. Let's take this demo. طبعا هنا في عندنا on the right hand side we have an input image like a house or a building. Now we applied the edge using Robert's operator with taking the threshold t equals 15. And here we take another threshold value, which is equal to t 50. F1. طيب شو رايك وايش المشكله باثنين؟ طبعا واضح انه البارت الاول او الجزء الاول لما اخذنا t equals 15 هذا اوفر استيميت ذا ايجز، يعني انت اعطيت الثريشولد فاليو سمول، هذا بيعطيني a lot of edges in the image. فانت you اوفر استيميت ذا ايج كونتنت. In case of t equals 15 you underestimate لانه اخذت الثريشولد العالي فيو overestimate يو سوري يو underestimate the edge content. عشان هيك صار في بعض الديتيلز زي هذه المناطق مثلا اللي هون يعني يا دوب واضحه، الجهه الثانيه نفس الشيء يا دوب واضحه هون، فاحنا حصلنا على edge صحيح لكن كانت عددها قليل او مش perfect. زي ما انتم شايفين when we change the threshold the results can be dramatically changed and this will give us a variation in our selection of this threshold. Okay, any questions? طيب حد بيعرف الروبرتس كروس ايدج اوبريتر؟ في شيء اسمه روبرتس كروس ايدج ديتكتور، شو رايكو؟ حد عنده فكره؟ Let's go now to directional edge operators. So as you see in the Roberts operator, there is no direction available for the edge. Now, in directional edge operators, we are going to look for the edge both in horizontal and vertical directions, then combine into a single metric. يعني when we try to project the edge on the vertical direction, on the horizontal direction, then according to these projections, we can define the angle of this edge. So, هذا واضح انه in this case we need once we have two directions so we need to apply two matrices or kernel matrices or masks, one is horizontal one is vertical. So we first apply convolution with the mask in horizontal direction, we call it the horizontal matrix مثلا, and then we apply the convolution in the vertical direction, another mask. And then having these two results, we can combine and get the exact direction of the edge at this point. Once we have the two projections of the edge on these two vertical and horizontal directions. Again, we have two equations. One is exact and the other one is approximate. بالنسبة للvalue or the magnitude, you need to find the square root, the squaring of the two resulting values from the operators, horizontal and vertical, and combine to get the magnitude as squaring of the squares, square root of the squares. If you want an approximate and quick or a little bit with higher speed, you can apply the magnitude only, absolute value. This is regarding the value. Then you can apply a threshold, whether higher than threshold or less than threshold. Now, to get the angle, the phase or the direction of the pixel edge at this point, or the edge in the pixel, you take the tan inverse of G vertical on G horizontal. So we have added here a direction with an angle theta. This is the main idea behind using the directional edge operators. Okay. Uh, We have here two examples on operators that can be used for jurisdiction based on the first derivative and defining the angle, so directional edge operators. So let's have a look on this equation. Oh, sorry, on this mask. This is A and this is B, and we call this this is for Sobel, Sim Alam Sobel. And we have this is the one is the horizontal, and this one is the vertical. Then we need to sense or to taste the flavor of the numbers inside the mask, because by changing these numbers, you can change the whole process, whether it is for edge detection, for low pass filtration, etc. As in Chevin, we have H. We have one row. 1 minute, please. كان هنا احنا we have one row minus one minus two minus one. Here we have nothing almost in the middle line, and in the last line we have one two one. يعني ايش بالضبط هاي الماتريكس تعمل؟ How we can guess what is the operation of this mask? انت by convolution شو بدك تعمل؟ You need to slide this matrix on the image. On the image. إذا راح تعمل إيش؟ راح تضرب الرقم minus 1 بالبكسل اللي وراه، minus 2 بالبكسل اللي وراه، minus 1 بالبكسل اللي وراه، بعدين راح تضرب في 1، في 2، في 1. أنت كأنك إيش عملت؟ ضربت الأرقام ب minus 1 and minus 2، وبعدين ضربت في 1 و 2 1. طبعًا هذا الزيرو راح يطير، الزيرو راح إيش؟ خلينا بس نشيل شوية من الخرابيش هاي. الزيرو راح يطير. هذا تقريبًا ولا شيء. هنا احنا ضربنا minus 1 minus 2 minus 1 1 2 1. طيب هو يعني نوع من ايش؟ انت اخذت الفاليوز الموجوده بهذا السطر، اعطيتهم different weights، وطرحتهم الفاليوز بهذا السطر، واعطيتهم اعطيت ويت اكبر لمين؟ اعطيت ويت اكبر للبكسل اللي بالنص اللي هو 2 minus 2. طبعا احنا عندنا الكرنت فاليو اللي بنشتغل عليه وينه؟ يعني سنتر بيكسل وين راح يكون؟ سنتر بيكسل راح يكون بالنص ان ميدل، بينما البيكسل نفسه ما دخلته والسطر اللي هو فيه اصلا لغيته. فانت كانك تعمل هوريزونتال ديتكشن للسطر اللي قبل مطروح من منه سطر او مطروح من السطر اللي بعد مع ويت مختلف، الى اعطى ويت اكبر للي بالنص للبيكسل اللي كان قبل وبعد بالعمود. هون لا، بالجهه الثانيه شو عندي؟ فيرتيكال، نفس عملنا روتيشن للماتريكس وحصلنا على شكل ايش؟ للفيرتيكال، يعني جينا طرحنا هذول من هذول مع طاويه مختلف، واللي بالنص ايش مالهم؟ تركناهم ما استخدمناهم. ليش؟ لانه ضربناهم في صفر. When you apply zero multiplication, this means you skip these values. طيب حصلنا على two values, we look for the threshold and after that we can find the angle as tan inverse ال G vertical على G horizontal. الآن بالنسبة للنوع الثاني أو الإكزامبل الثاني اللي هو بروت. بروت شوي أسهل، أعطى ويت متساوي minus 1 و 1، يعني كأنه أعطى البكسلز كلهم إيش؟ نفس الويت horizontal and vertical. بينما السوبل شو أعطى؟ أعطى ويت أعلى لمين؟ للبكسل اللي بيقع على نفس قبل السطر وبعد السطر أو قبل بعمود أو بعد بعمود، والباقي أعطاهم ويت أقل 1 وماينس 1 وبين هون 2 وماينس 2. أما البروت شو أعطى؟ أعطى نفس الويت فور أول بيكسلز وذين ذيس ماتريكس. طبعا كل واحد له بنفيت، بيختلف الريزلتس كثير؟ لا ما بيختلف كثير، لكن it could يعني give sometimes improvement using the Sobel operator because you are applying more weight for the pixel at the center location or under consideration. Example. هاي كان image fragment, small segment of the image, and you are asked to find three things. Numbers جوا هاي الماتريكس عبارة عن pixel gray levels. الآن قال لك طلع لي edge operator detector بحيث يعطيني ال edges، وبعدين طلع لي ال magnitude phase لكل pixel بالصورة هاي. طبعا this is a lot of work. We can repeat for one pixel and do for others similarly. And apply a threshold. أول مرة أعطاك threshold point يعني 31% من maximum يعني تدور على الماكسيم فاليو وتطلع threshold as 31% of the maximum. المرة الثانية قال لك لا استخدم threshold 500 وحدد لي الانجل بالذات الثيتا اذا كانت ما بين 44.5 و45.5 which means we want to define a theta roughly speaking around 45 degrees. يعني في عندنا ايش؟ الانجل اللي كان 45 degrees طلع الايدج بيكسلز او البيكسلز فيهم ايدجز with an angle of 45 degrees. This is the main يعني question is the in this numerical example. Let's go to the solution and see what to do now. طبعا زي ما اخذنا في المحاضرة الماضية we need to apply zero padding. الماتريكس بتاعت الكيرنل 3x3 الزيرو بادينج بضيف it adds one row before one row after one column before and one column after like a frame of one pixel of zero pixels. طبعا هاي عندنا الصوب الاوبريتور horizontal and vertical وعملت الزيرو بادينج اللي صارت على الصورة هاي الايمج الاوريجينال سوري هيك عندنا and we apply zero padding of as you see here we have one row and one column before and after لأن الماتريكس سايز 3x3 فبنضيف حتى إذا عشان إذا كنا على البكسل لوكيشن مثلا في هاي النقطة اختار لون ثاني نعمل ويندو فوق المنطقة هاي يكون عندنا ايش؟ اوفرلابينج مع اللي وراه واللي بصير برا الصورة now 4G11 we just need to multiply the values in the matrix or the kernel or the edge operator مع الماتريكس على البكسل ات لوكيشن 1 1. طبعا هذا لوكيشن 1 1 عندنا فيرست بكسل ات فيرست رو اند فيرست كولم تمام بنطلع الكالكوليشنز ل هاي البوينتس as you see here we have جي اتش 1 1 just multiplication and we get the value of 121 and we repeat the same thing with the other matrix for the vertical and we get another value 113 لانه اخذنا الابسولوت فاليو جمعنا اخذنا اللي هي الابروكسيميت فاليو 234 instead of taking the square and for tan inverse we take for the vertical divided by the horizontal and take the tan inverse for this value and this gave us a value of as you see here we have a value of angle of 34.04. Next, what we do? The next slide. We are at here. Now we move further one pixel forward, and we are now located. We are now located on the second pixel at this point, and we repeat. With the matrices, kernels, horizontal and vertical, and get the final value and final angle. الفكرة واضحة يا شباب صح؟
واضحة واضحة دكتور.
تمام، احنا بنكمل الاوبريشن مرة ثانية. This is what we have got for all values. طبعا عندنا العملية كل مرة حتى خلصنا لما كملنا شلنا الزيرو بادنج على الدائرة ونفذنا الفاليو والانجل زي ما تشوفين هون. اوكي؟ Next what to do؟ خلصنا فرع A أو بارت A. And part B شو طالب مني؟ أطلع الثريشولد طبعا بروح على إذا بنرجع لهون we look for the maximum value. وين في عندنا ماكسيم فاليو هون؟ على قيمة كان 1118 صح؟ 1118 اوكي؟ So this is Gmax equals 1118 تمام؟ So this is the maximum value according to step 2 or to part 2 we need to find the threshold as 31% of the maximum And this gave us a value of 335.4. عملنا في الثريشولد على وين؟ على الايمج again. Now, as you see here, we have a value of 0 because the value is less than threshold. While we have here, for example, 255, this is 0 and this is 1. This is logic 0 and this is logic 1. Okay, which will be 255 gray level. All points having a value more than threshold are set to 255, otherwise are set to 0. تقريبا صار عندنا almost we can see the edge direction or يعني على الأقل في البداية we can see that we have something like this as an edge here at this point. We have also edges here, but these edges are caused by the zero padding. Usually we can skip these edges at the border. We are not including them in the calculations or in our decision for next step. زي حكيتكم we just need to remove the edge the outer pixels لأنه هذول جينات لأنه أضفت zero padding فأي value مع الزيرو حصير يعطيني edge. So we can guess the edge locations, edge pixel locations. Here yeah, we have to remember that we have had added a frame of zeros in the zero padding, and in this case we need to remove the outer pixels from our calculations. As here we have empty or zero values for the pixels. We did not include all outer pixels in this image or in this resulting edge matrix. And this is this indicates that we have almost something like a 45 edge direction, like this one. And this is it could be the final answer for this part. Okay, now let's go forward to part C. In part C, we are asked to find to apply thresholding instead of taking the threshold as 35% of the max. We can do it using a constant or a given specific value for the threshold, which is t equals 500. We can repeat the process and get another matrix for the resulting edge for this case. So this is the result for gx of g of xy, and this is the resulting edge angles at every pixel location. In degrees for sure. Now we can use the threshold. As here we have all these values are above the threshold 500, and sure we excluded all outer edges here because they are caused by the zero padding. Here we have a demo, an example on these obtained results for the same original image on the right hand side. On the left hand side, this is the original image as in the previous example. Here we have a threshold of T30, and here we have for the horizontal also for T30. So we here obtain the horizontal edges, and here we have the vertical edges. We can combine both images in one image and get one final G value by just adding the two images together. And this will give us an edge magnitude with T equals 30. Now we can see another example with different value for the threshold. Here we have t equals 15. This already combined result. This one is a combined result for both horizontal and vertical edges. And this one is the same thing when we have t equals 50. As you see, t equals 13, 15 overestimates the H content, while t equals 50 underestimates the H content. And we need something between 15 and 50. And this is up to your choice and your flavor and taste of edges in the image. You can select your own. And this threshold actually can be fixed when we are dealing with specific class of images. For example, taking coming from thermal images, coming from natural images, from RGB images for a specific application, and you can select their a specific or a proper threshold to get a good and proper output edge detection. Now let's go and see another example for Prewitt. Similarly as in the case of the Sobel, we have here t equals 30 for horizontal and vertical. If you combine, you can get the final result of edge magnitude with t equals 30. And now in this image, you can see both or two different examples. One when t equals, 15 and t equals 50. They are very similar in case of Prewitt and Sobel. And sometimes we may have some slight change. However, you can use both. For sure, Prewitt is easier because you do not multiply by 2. You just multiply by 1 and minus 1. And this is easier and quicker in computer applications. And this gives you an ability to speed up your process. What about this demo? We have here the original image as color image, RGB image. And here we have got the edge image. What do you think? How we could get results in edge detection with colors or colored? Of course, here the colors in the edge detection doesn't have a very important meaning. What do you think? How we can get the colors, or how to get the edge detection for color images? في حد بيعرف؟
دكتور نفس يعني نفس ما كنا نساوي من نعمل نفصل كل كومبوننت لحال
yes.
او بنحوله للواي سي بقى.
يعني we have two approaches. هذول دائما معنا شغالات. Two approaches. RGB split into RG and B layers. Apply the edge detection on every layer. Then combine the result. Or take the Y CBCR of the RGB. Apply your operation to the Y. Then get your RGB image by converting the obtained Y plus the C and CR, CB and CR from the original one, and combine them. Then go back to the RGB color domain.